Hello students, myself Kitika Srivastav from Madhara Sindhya Public School. I am a science teacher. Previously I had given you lecture on life processes. Now today I will be giving you the lecture on the first life process, that is nutrition. It will be covering the following topics: what is nutrition, modes of nutrition, nutrition in plants, conditions necessary for photosynthesis, raw material for photosynthesis and site of photosynthesis. Now, first of all, what is nutrition? Basically, the process of taking in food and utilizing it, it is known as nutrition. Now, what the term utilizing, taking it in, is simple, that is the process of ingestion of food as you are eating the food. Yes, and then the food breakdowns to release energy, that is utilization of food, that is known as nutrition. Now the word nutrition, it is derived from the word nutrient, which means a substance which an organism obtains from the surroundings and uses as a source of energy. Now nutrient can be carbohydrates, fats, proteins, minerals, vitamins and water, because all of these they are giving us energy. So nutrients are what? Which we are obtaining from the surroundings, which we are using as a source of energy. After this, modes of nutrition. There are mainly two modes of nutrition, autotrophic and heterotrophic. Coming on to the first one, which is autotrophic nutrition. It is made up of two words, auto and trophos. Auto is self, trophos is nutrition. Self nutrition. So, organism which makes its own food from simple inorganic substances like carbon dioxide and water, that is known as autotrophic nutrition. It is of two types, photoautotrophs and chemoautotrophs. Everybody is familiar with photoautotrophs because we always give the example as plants. Plants, what they are doing is they are utilizing the sunlight. So these are known as photoautotrophs because plants synthesize food with the help of sunlight and chlorophyll, and it converts carbon dioxide and water to glucose and oxygen. Now, whereas chemoautotrophs, they are also doing the autotrophic kind of nutrition because these are some of the chemosynthetic bacteria which are utilizing the chemical energy. They are making the food from the chemical substances. So these are termed as chemoautotrophs. Next is heterotrophic nutrition, in which organism cannot make its own food and is dependent on others for its food. Example, non-green plants and animals. There are different types of heterotrophic nutrition. First of all, saprotrophic nutrition, as the bread molds. Many must have seen that cottony outgrowth on the bread. That is because of the fungus. So this kind of organism, they obtain the food from dead and decaying organic matter. Some more examples are for saprotrophic nutrition is yeast, mushroom and many of the bacteria. Then parasitic nutrition, organism which derive its food from the other body of the other living host without killing. So it is deriving the food from the host. Parasite is deriving the food from the host. There are two kind of parasites, ectoparasites and endoparasites. Ectoparasites which live on the body of the host, as leech and mosquito, whereas endoparasites are those which live inside the body of the host. Examples are Plasmodium and roundworms. Roundworms, they live inside the intestine and they eat the digested food. So the person used to feel hungry all the time because the digested food is consumed by roundworms. So now the difference is clear. Difference between ectoparasite and endoparasite. Ectoparasite is basically which is living on the body of the host, whereas endoparasite which is living inside the body of the host. Then comes holozoic nutrition. organism which feeds on complex organic food by the process of ingestion. The ingested food is digested and absorbed in the body. Example, cat, dog and man. The most common example, you can take the example of man. What we are doing is, we are eating the food, yes, as a whole, and then what we are doing, we are digesting it. So this kind of nutrition is holozoic nutrition.